The United States is sanctioning three North Korean hacking groups, the Lazarus Group, Bluenoroff, and Andariel. The U.S. Department of the Treasury claims the three groups are behind a host of cyber attacks designed to spy on adversaries and generate revenue for Pyongyang's controversial nuclear weapons and ballistic missile programs. The sanctions freeze all of the hacking groups' property and interests in the U.S., as well as those of other entities that are owned 50% or more by the three groups. They're controlled by North Korea's primary intelligence agency, the Reconnaissance General Bureau, or RGB. The RGB is already under US and UN sanctions as well. The US seems to be keeping its pressure campaign against the North while seeking resumption of denuclearization talks. This week right now, we'll look into the three North Korean hacking groups and their main hacking cases. The best known of the three sanctioned groups is Lazarus, created by North Korean government as early as 2007. The FBI tied Lazarus to the 2014 hack of Sony Pictures. It destroyed data on thousands of company computers and published embarrassing emails from company executives to avenge a film depicting the assassination of North Korea's leader. But the best known work widely attributed to Lazarus was the WannaCry ransomware outbreak in 2017. Within hours, WannaCry had spread to 150 countries and shut down an estimated 300,000 computers. The new sanctions also apply to two Lazarus subgroups. The first is known as Bluenoroff and the other is Andariel. In 2016, Andariel hacked into the then South Korean defense minister's personal computer and the defense ministry intranet in order to extract military operations intelligence. Meanwhile, Bluenoroff was behind a 2016 hack on a Bangladesh central bank that almost got away with stealing $851 million. A typographical error prevented the illicit transaction from going through, but the attackers still made off with $81 million. In addition, the three North Korean groups have also targeted virtual asset providers and cryptocurrency exchanges. According to the Treasury, the three hacking groups likely stole around $571 million in cryptocurrency from five exchanges in Asia between January 2017 and September 2018. A recent UN report estimated that North Korean hacking has generated $2 billion for the country's weapons of mass destruction programs. The latest Treasury measures come just days after US President Donald Trump fired his National Security Advisor John Bolton, known for his hardline stance against Pyongyang. There had been speculation that Bolton's sacking could signal Washington adopting a softer stance toward North Korea. But the latest announcement can be interpreted to the contrary. The US might want to keep its pressure against the North while maintaining dialogue leading up to the resumption of their denuclearization negotiations later this month. What are your thoughts on this? Please let me know in the comments below, and thank you for watching Korea Now.